Hey, what's going on, guys? Today we are inside of Affinity Publisher and I wanted to create a quick video based on a question I was asked, and that is whether or not you can apply a second stroke to your text. So although you can't directly do this inside of Affinity Publisher, there is a bit of a workaround providing you have Affinity Designer installed as well. So if you guys have both those programs installed on your system, then I'll show you how we can go ahead and do this. So first thing we want to do is create a new canvas and go and grab our text tool. Then we're just going to write out any kind of text that you would like to use. So I'm just going to write in stroke on this. And I'll just select that move tool so I can just resize that a little bit just to fit it on the screen. So in order to apply our first stroke, this is pretty straightforward. We're going to go over to the right hand side and we're going to change our color here from being white to anything that you would like. I'll go for red just to make this quick and easy. So now we've got this selected around our black. If we want to go ahead and change the size of this stroke, it's a case of coming over to the right hand side once again into our stroke menu. Then we can just change the width to be anything that we like, as well as go ahead and change that color if you don't like it. So if you now decide that you want an extra stroke outside of this red one, then the way we could do that is by going into Affinity Designer. And we're going to do that by switching the persona on the top left hand side. And we'll choose the Affinity Designer. So once we are inside of here, you can see that we've got our layer that we've got inside of Affinity Publisher. And we've got this menu up here called Appearance. If you guys aren't seeing this appearance menu, then just simply go up to your view menu, go down to where it says studio, and just make sure you've got your appearance checked. So at the moment, we can see inside of the appearance menu that we have the add stroke option and the add fill. At the moment, these are not highlighted and we cannot use them. And this can't be applied on text. And this is why it becomes a bit of a workaround. So if I just go back over to Affinity Publisher and I'm going to draw myself a shape just to demonstrate how this will work. So we can draw a triangle inside of Affinity Publisher. Then we can go ahead and make our way back up to the designer persona. Then once we're back inside of here, you can now see on the right hand side that we have the add stroke and add fill feature available. So this is because we are now on the shape and not the text. And if I want to go ahead and put a second stroke onto this triangle, it's just a case of selecting this add stroke option right there, changing that color to be something different. So I'm going to go for a blue. I'm going to change the size by selecting the points right there and change the width, make that a little bit bigger. And at the moment, we can't see the stroke underneath it because it's a lot smaller than the blue one. So if we go back into the red and open up the points option and we make that width a lot bigger as well, we can now see that we've got this on the outside of the blue. If you want to switch this around to be on the inside, you would do that inside of the alignment option right there, just by simply selecting that option. So you can see we can switch in between the inside and the outside. So like I said, this is because we are on a shape and not text. So in order for us to do this on some text, we need to convert this text into a curve, which in theory is going to create that into its own custom shape. So in order to do that, we're just going to go ahead and select the text. Then we'll go and right click on our mouse. We're going to go down to where it says convert to curves. And now if we make our way back over to the right hand side and we open up our little drop down triangle, we can see all these individual letters. And now you can see that we also have the add stroke and add fill available in each one of these letters. So what we need to do now is just select the top letter, which is going to be the E. We're going to hold down the shift button and select the one at the bottom, which is the S in my case. Then I'm going to make my way up to the top menu bar and I'm going to use the add function right there, which is going to stick these all together one layer. So if we were to leave that the way it was, we would have had to do each individual layer on its own when it comes to applying its own stroke or fill. And this way we can do it as a whole. So I'm just going to drag the outside of the group because we don't need the group anymore. And I'll go ahead and delete that. So with our stroke text now selected, we can go ahead and add another stroke to this. So we'll go ahead and select that option. Give that a different color like we did before. Go for purple this time. Make that a little bit bigger. And once again, we want to change the thickness of the one underneath it so we can see that as well. And we can go ahead and change the color of that one to maybe be a green. Go back in here and just change the alignment options. Just like that. So you can see how we're all starting to come together. And you can just add as many strokes on top of this as you like. So if we select this again and we add another stroke, and we'll just give that its own color as well, maybe a blue just to be quick. So what I also want to do at this point is we want to work out the arrangement that we've got going on here. As when we apply strokes, it kind of works its way from the inside out. So if I drag this blue one now down below the green, this is going to be the first one that we're going to need so we can see it on the outside. And the way we do that is we're going to make it a lot bigger. So if we make the width a lot bigger now, we can see this overtake the green just like that. And that is because it is coming from the inside out. And looking at this at the moment, we've got this kind of weird black effect going on inside it. And that is because our stroke is actually a lot bigger than the text itself. So you can just go ahead and correct that just by simply changing the size of the stroke, just making that a lot smaller so we can see the black as normal again, or just bringing that back out so we can see it. And of course, like I said, you can add as many of these as you like. It does look really ridiculous with these color choices that I've made right here. So once you've got what you are happy with, we can then just go back over to our publisher persona and we can continue to work inside of here with whatever it is you want to do. However, one thing that I do want to mention is that even though we can always go back to our designer persona and we can just keep on changing these colors and our thickness, one thing that we can't do is edit the text. So once we've converted this to curves and it's created it into a shape, we are then stuck with the word that we have wrote. So this is important that you make sure you are happy with anything you wrote before you go ahead and proceed with this. Or you are just going to have to go ahead and just type out something else altogether and just start all over again. And I know this is a bit of a pain and it should be a lot more straightforward than this, but at the moment, this is the only way I could figure out how to do this. But if you guys also know an alternative way, then go ahead and let me know in the comments. So I hope you found this video useful. If you did, then please go ahead and hit that like button as that really helps me out with the YouTube algorithm and helps other people find my content. And of course, if you haven't already, then go ahead and hit that subscribe button and check out all of my future releases as well as any other videos I've already created using Affinity Publisher, Designer or Photo. But for now, I hope you have a great day and I will see you in the next video.